Why is this error coming to me? The term Streamlit is not recognized as a as the name of the cmd. I have Python, I have VS Code. I don't know what to do. Are you interested to know the solution? Then you're at the right place. Today we'll learn how to install Streamlit in Python, that is install Streamlit in VS Code. And this is the most frequent error that comes while installing Streamlit. And being a beginner, for example, someone like me who has a finance background gets stuck into things like this because we have no idea about the environment variables. We don't know anything about like what to do, etc. You'll not find any video on YouTube or not even a blog. So that's why I thought that I should make this video for you guys to install Streamlit and then use this web application for your personal uses. Hello guys, I'm Ritvik Dashura and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. I'm making a playlist on Streamlit, and you guys already know that I make videos on financial programming, that is implementing things in finance, in the world of finance using technology. I've made videos on multiple models like Monte Carlo simulation, value at risk, etc. And things like trading bot using some highly valuable financial APIs in Python, etc. etc. So if this is something that you're interested in, then smash on the subscribe button and hit on the bell icon. And also, because there's a playlist that I'm making on Streamlit, the first video would be on what is Streamlit and how to install it, because most of us get stuck in this thing only, like they cannot even install Streamlit in VS Code. The second video would be on like what all different functionalities of Streamlit are useful, and the third video would be on making a financial dashboard. So please stay tuned to this playlist and also subscribe to my YouTube channel. Looking at the usage of Streamlit, Streamlit is basically an open source web application framework that is that can be accessed through Python language, and it can be used for multiple data science and machine learning programs. Definitely we can use Streamlit for machine learning and AI as well, but in this video, to make it quite easy for you guys to understand, I'm not going to use anything in machine learning or AI, and I'll just like focus on correct usage of Streamlit. We'll be making a financial dashboard in the third video that I'll be uploading in this playlist, and I'll just try to keep things very very simple. If I get comments on like on making some videos on machine learning as well, then definitely I'll try to cover those things as well. So basically the main idea is this, that we get a web application using a Streamlit. This web application is like a front-end platform that you can use to interact with the Python code that runs in the background. You can use this to make a website as well, although some other tools are used more frequently to build a website, things like React, for example. In this case, I'm just going to stick to the basic usage of making simple Streamlit web application framework. So guys, coming to the error that we are getting, that is the term Streamlit is not recognized and so on. It's definitely a big problem, and the main reason for this issue is environment variables. Now what the hell is environment variables? Basically we need to provide the address of Python and Python scripts that are present in our local system in the environment variable, such that it can be used in this VS Code to trigger any particular thing. So basically we have two solutions here for you. The first one is to put relevant paths in the environment variables that I'm talking about, and the second one is very very easy that I'll talk in some time. So let's just look at the variable path first. I'll just go here in the start button and just write environment variables, right? If you click here, you'll see this environment variable here. Over there you just need to go to path segment and then click on edit. You can see there's no Python here. So what we need to what we'll have to do here is we'll just go to new and provide the address where your Python is saved. So I'll go back here. I'll just click write Python here, right click, open file location, again right click, open file location. So yeah, this is the file location that I have. So what I need to do here is Control C is the path of this particular folder, click new, Control V, then another click, one more time click new, go back to the folder scripts, again Control C, come here new, paste this particular path and then click OK, and then OK. That's it. This is what you need to do guys, and then this will run. So you'll have to restart this thing. So I'll just close it and open it again. So guys, I restarted the VS Code, and if I just write over here, if I just write Streamlit run and then testing.py, if you guys have no idea what I'm doing right now, just I'll do everything in the second video, just wait for some time. If I enter this thing, you'll see that you have the localhost file this, and it automatically opened here a web application on on my Google Chrome, and you can see that it's localhost 8501 here. This is solution number one. If you guys are still facing some difficulty to do the entire thing, what you can do here is, let's go to control panel, uninstall this entire. So the first step would be to uninstall the entire Python launcher and Python that you have. So I'll just uninstall this. Meanwhile, it is getting uninstalled. You guys would have might be facing the difficulty here as well. So if I just go to select interpreter, because what I've done here is basically I went to the control palette, and over here just like select interpreter, I can just write it here as well to get to this one. So select interpreter, and then you can see there's one path over here. You guys might be having two different paths here. This is another problem that people face very frequently. There's one path here because this particular Python, if you can see, this app data local programs and Python, and then Python 3.11, right? This is the Python program that I installed externally, right? There's one that we can install internally in VS Code through Microsoft Store. Yeah, that is another problem, and that, like, putting that into environment variable is very, very difficult, guys. So if you have installed Python through Microsoft Store, just go to here, just go to Microsoft Store, go to Python here. Mostly this would be installed in your computer. If I just click here, go here, and then uninstall this. So I don't have it. So you'll have to uninstall this thing. Please don't use Python that from Microsoft Store. This would be running perfectly fine, but putting it into the environment variables would be a really, really difficult and tough task. And this was the thing that I myself was actually facing a lot of trouble into. That's why the best thing here is to not install this particular Python that is through Microsoft Store. Uninstall it right away. I think by now our Python would have been installed. Yeah, so this has been uninstalled. If I close my VS Code and open it again, I should be getting an error here. Perfect. So you can see a red line over here. If I say run this particular code, then you'll see that there's no interpreter selected over here. So we can check it again here by clicking on this command palette, which is Control Shift P, and click here and just write interpreter, and click here. You'll see there's no Python installed. Perfect. That's absolutely fine. Now we'll go to the website Python install Python, the connection timed out. So I'll just close this one as well. So this is the website that you can use to download Python, the most updated version of Python. I click here. Let's install. I clicked over here. Let's install this. And now here is the main key. You'll have to click on add python.exe to path. If you had done this thing previously, then you would not have got this particular error and then install this thing. So it will automatically put all the relevant paths in the environment variables. You don't need to do anything over there. It was as simple as that. So yeah, it's done. I'll close the VS Code again. I'll go back to the command palette, select interpreter. Over here I can see Python is recommended, which I will click here. Just do pip install Streamlit here again. If you run this thing, you'll get, like, you'll install Streamlit. Just again click here, write Streamlit run and then testing.py. If I enter this, you'll see that we have got this localhost and automatically open Streamlit. So yeah, this is the way you can install Streamlit and use it. In the next video, I will talk about the functionalities of Streamlit, and I'm not going to tell you all different types of functionalities, definitely, because I'm the finance guy, and so I'll just focus on the things that can be used in the world of finance. I'm not going to do any complicated stuff here. So please stay tuned. The next video will be on the usage of Streamlit, and the video after that would be on making financial dashboard that would be referring to first and the second video. If you like my video, please click on the subscribe button and also the like button. That's really, really important for me. And if you would like to support my work, you can click on the Patreon logo over here and become a Patreon member. And this is not just a support, you will get many benefits also, because I am connected with all the Patreon members that I have, and it's an amazing experience that I give to all my Patreon members. So please consider joining my Patreon community. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.